a year ago, if you asked me to introduce myself. Hello?
Yeah.
Okay, it's not working. A year ago, if you asked me to introduce myself, I would have said, my name is Momoko Mandere, and I am half Asian, half African. Or, if I wanted to switch things up a bit, I would have said, I'm half black, half Asian. But the main point is, I always considered myself as being black. And I never actually questioned this. I never actually asked, why did I not consider myself complete? Why did I not consider myself enough? Until somebody asked me that. So, just to give you a quick overview of who exactly I am the product of two wonderful, incredible, complicated people whose parents aren't really. My mom is this incredibly brave woman from India. And my father is this intellectual, resilient man from Zimbabwe. My mother is Asian. My father is black. And I? Where do I fit into this narrative? Well, for the longest time, that's what my society and me have been trying to answer. So, if I was to fill out a Census Bureau, I would be classified as biracial. Biracial meaning concerning or containing members of two racial groups. This is according to the Merriam-Webster Dictionary. So, on the outside, the definition seems pretty straightforward, right? I mean, it's just two races put together. But of course, like many things in life that we think and we hope are simple, they rarely ever are. So this is a picture of me and my brother when I was a lot younger. And I mean, I hope I grew a bit. So I grew up in a lower income suburb in Harare. My entire community was black. And from the very moment that I gained consciousness, I realized that I was different from my peers. And not in a cool, I'm different way, but in a, no, genuinely we have to have a conversation about this. Because it wasn't just my hair that separated me, it was my skin tone, my belief system. In a community that was made up of incredible people who identified as black, I stuck out. My family stuck out. So, you at this point may be asking, why does it matter? Why does it matter if one biracial person in the world feels like they don't really belong in the community? Well, the truth is, I'm not the only one. Mixed race people, biracial people, are the fastest growing demographic across the world, not just in the continent. Within Africa, for every 99 marriages, one of them will be a mixed race, interracial marriage. In the 125th edition of the National Geographic, they predicted that by 2050, the most common racial status in America will be mixed race. And in Brazil, the numbers just keep growing. Our demographic is rapidly changing. We are becoming more and more common. But the question is, as our demographic changes, is our rhetoric around race changing enough? Are we evolving quickly enough to handle the nuances that are the lives of biracial and mixed race people? Yes, our demographic is different, but is our rhetoric, are our conversations around race different enough? So an interesting study was done by the American Psychological Association in 2013. And something they realized was that teenagers who identified as being mixed race or biracial were more likely to suffer from depression. If you felt that you hadn't grown up with a strong racial identity, if you felt confused about where you belonged in the world, you were more likely to suffer from microaggressions from racism you're more likely to face racial discrimination during your life. Teenagers, people like me, who had grown up in two different worlds, two different cultures, were more likely to identify with the statement, "I feel alone." So, here's the thing. We clearly have a problem, but what can we do about it? Because as much as we have problems, there must be solutions. And something that I could propose is, well, it's based on something that happened to me, once again, a year ago. So I was giving a presentation, and after the presentation, a woman came up to me. She was extremely thrilled, and I thought it was because, oh, I had spoken well or something, or maybe there had been a point that she had identified with. But no, the actual reason was she had her 8-year-old daughter with her, and her 8-year-old daughter was also mixed race. And her 8-year-old daughter was so thankful that she had actually, for the first time, seen someone who was mixed race and wearing an afro, because that had been something she had never seen. Not in movies, not read in books, not seen in television. She had never seen anyone like her giving a speech. And that was something that inspired her. And so that was what the woman was thanking me about. She was thanking me for representation. And when you think about it, at its core, that is what we all need. That is what biracial and mixed race people, not just within the globe, but especially within the continent, we need more representation. We are nuanced. Our existence in of itself is complicated. We are a product of colonialism and neocolonialism. We are different, and we need those conversations around us to include those differences. When we talk about how Africa is the changing revolution, when we talk about how Africa's youth are going to change the continent, we need to acknowledge that the youth of Africa, the demographic that is changing, is different, and they need to be represented. When we see movies, we need to see that mixed race people are also part of the continent. When we read books, when our politicians engage in conversations around racial politics in Africa, mixed race and biracial people need to be included in those conversations. And finally, for those, whether you be mixed race, biracial, or not, for those who feel like they don't fit into the boxes of African, for those who feel like society has drawn up a list of what makes a person count as being African or Asian or Caucasian, and they feel like they don't fit those boxes, it's okay. You don't have to fill in all of the boxes. You don't have to call yourself blackish if you really truly feel that you're black. You're not a bad Asian. And you can be white if you want to be. You are more than just a simple race. You're more than a census box. You are complete. You are enough.